Yeah, I started playing when I was about 3 years old, and I think that's where it all kicked off. I played all sports throughout primary school and high school. I actually, funny enough, went to high school on a cricket scholarship, and that changed very quickly when in my second year I started playing water polo. But yeah, I've got a massive love for sport, but right through my school career I knew that when I'm done with school I'd love to get into golf, and in 2018 I turned professional. And yeah, after a season and a half on tour, that's where I am at the moment. To put a finger on why I knew I'd play golf is quite difficult. I think having to rely solely on yourself when you're playing is something that I really enjoy. I think it was Tiger who said in an interview a couple of weeks ago at the Masters that no one's going to take you off the mound or sub you out of the game. No matter what's going on, you have to figure out a way to get it done. And that really appeals to me, as well as the fact that you can absolutely never master it. That annoys the hell out of me, but it's also probably the biggest driving factor that every single day, coming to practice or play, you're going to learn something, you're going to get better, but you'll never get to a point where you are done learning. And I think that is where the physical transformation took place as well. I joined Gavin Groves at HBC in I think 2012-2013. I was roughly as tall as I am now, 206, but I was, some people called me a Chinese fighting snake. I was about 85 kilos coming out of school, and riddled with injuries, and I think that came from growing so ridiculously quickly in such a short space of time. And Gavin and I slowly worked our way into a plan which has carried me through, I think, the last 6 or 7 years of training. I picked up, cheapest, I think it's about 35 kilos in those 6 years or 7 years, which has, I think, been a byproduct of what we wanted to do, because I think the heart behind the training was essentially to avoid injury and control the forces at play in the swing a lot better. And yeah, it's something that I've fallen in love with. I think it's just as important as the technical side of the mental aspect is the physical aspect of the game, and I think you can't ignore it. Nowadays, I think if you look at the top 10 in the world, all of them have a massive power element to their game. But luckily enough, even when I was quote unquote a Chinese fighting snake, I never really struggled with distance to hit the ball far or anything like that. But what the training has helped me with is to control that aspect of my game a lot better. I think having the different gears, so to speak, that you can shift through to carry certain bunkers or whatever it might be is definitely massively beneficial. But it's provided an element of control to that power, which has been, I think, what we were after initially as well.